So our next question regarding hormone therapy is, this person's kind of saying, is chemical castration through hormone therapy the same thing as an orchiectomy? And obviously an orchiectomy is when they remove the testicles, but that seems like a permanent thing where hormone therapy is temporary. Am I right in my thinking that it's the same kind of mechanism, but a temporary action?
It is the same. If you're talking about the common injectable hormone blockade agents like Lupron, Trelstar, Firmagon, Zoladex, Eligard, it's a medically equivalent to a surgical castration, except that it is reversible. It's not medically equivalent to something like Xtandi, Zytiga, Nubeca, or Lita, which have the capacity to block testosterone inside the cancer cell. So this is one of the things about the nastier high-grade cancers, is that they learn how to make their own testosterone. And orchiectomy and Lupron-type drugs do not block that.
And as far as those types of hormone therapies go, once those are, you know, discontinued, will the person be able to regain their testosterone levels back after Zytiga or Xtandi or anything like that?
Yes. They are, in theory, all reversible. There is a problem in the more elderly men with tired and aged testicles. Some of these men that have been on Lupron for an extended period of time do not resume making testosterone at normal levels, even though they've been off treatment for 6 to 12 months.
So the next question is from a child of a prostate cancer patient. Their father is 86 years old, and he has prostate cancer in his pelvic lymph nodes. His urologist wanted to start him on Lupron, and he's kind of concerned about the quality of life. Would it be safe to try Casodex instead? Do they check the testosterone and PSA levels to see if the Casodex alone is enough to control the cancer without Lupron? I think he's just really concerned about the hormone therapy side effects at 86.
I think it's a very cogent concern. We know at age 86 that we're not going to be here forever. Perhaps he'll be happy if he can get another 5 to 10 years of survival, just under normal circumstances. So why not use a milder medicine with more predictable, reversible side effects like Casodex? It makes a lot of sense because you can monitor the PSA levels. You can continue doing scans to check the lymph nodes if they were picked up on a CAT scan, for example. And as long as the situation is in check with PSA levels controlled, most men describe better quality of life on Casodex than they do on Lupron. Less fatigue. Some men will even retain a little bit of libido on Casodex. You have to watch out for higher incidence of breast enlargement, but that can be blocked out with estrogen blockers like Femara or Arimidex. So I think it's a very cogent idea.
So our next question comes from a patient who is wondering about the possible side effects of radiation to the lymph nodes. Their doctor wants to do it prophylactically, and they're kind of worried about the side effects, and they'd rather wait and see if any disease appears on scans before treating pelvic lymph nodes with radiation automatically.
Well, a lot of this, if the person was elderly, perhaps they should wait. If they're younger, and the prostate world younger means and probably still in your 60s and early 70s, the idea of jumping ahead and zapping the lymph nodes to improve cure rates in someone that's going through treatment to be cured makes sense, because prophylactic radiation to the pelvic lymph nodes can be delivered at centers of excellence with very little side effects. So historically, lymph node radiation was a rather frightening concept, and many of the radiation therapists, though they were paid to do this, wouldn't do it because they saw so many ugly effects on the intestines, and which were long-lasting afterwards. It was skillful treatment. These days, that concern has been eliminated, and so in select patients who have high Gleason scores and high PSAs, in whom the doctors suspect lymph node involvement, prophylactic, or we call it adjuvant radiation therapy to the pelvic lymph nodes, makes a lot of sense.
Hey everyone, it's me and Sir Hunter the Dow, our PCRI mascot. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Hunter definitely wants you to. And if he can high-five me, you have to subscribe right now. Oh, you're already high-fiving me. Good job. Thanks so much. Visit our YouTube channel and also our website for more information at PCRI.org. Say bye.